We are now at the NOC, that's the Network Operations Center of ESDS. With me here is Mr. Anil Chandalia, head of the Network Operations team. Mr. Chandalia, we'd like to know, when the customers host their data on your server, the basic thing that every customer would be looking for is transparency and security. How is ESDS able to meet those criteria?
There are two things about the security. One is physical security and second is server security. For physical security, we have implemented 6 layers of security. Okay, we have implemented fencing around our campus. Starting from the gate, we have gunmen which keep being across the campus to monitor the activities. We have implemented surveillance cameras. We keep records of surveillance camera for a month. Okay, and on demand, if customer asks, we can provide the logs of cameras to our customer. These all cameras are motion-based cameras. If any motion happens, camera will immediately start recording that particular area. Okay. On the top of that, we have biometric access for our employees and for all visitors. And in biometrics, we have multiple levels of authentication. Like our support engineers, they are not supposed to come to NOC or they are not supposed to come to a data center. So we have a such kind of authentication layer. Only NOC engineers are allowed to go to data center or the NOC. Okay. We have recording of all access log machines. So if required, we can get incoming and outgoing data of all NOC engineers and users. On server level, on rack level, we provide cagings to our customers. Like if there is a banking customer, we provide caging solutions to our banking customers. In caging, we can provide biometric access, or we can provide physical lock. And in biometric, we will have dual authentication. Like one authentication will be of customer, and second authentication will be of data center engineer or NOC engineer, you can say. And these are the security point of view. From network point of view, we have implemented DDoS mitigation systems in our data center. DDoS is an attack which is done by a distributed system. If there is an attacker, he has a lot of zombies worldwide, and he starts attacking a particular host, a particular server, or you can say particular domain. And then in that case, it is a very huge bandwidth kind of attack, okay? Say 1 Gbps, 2 Gbps, 10 Gbps, and 40 Gbps. We have implemented anomalies, Cisco Anomaly Guard and Cisco Anomaly Detector, which are capable to mitigate DDoS level. There are 7 filtering levels in Anomaly Detector and Anomaly Guard, okay? In Anomaly Guard, we have done out-of-line configuration. In general firewall, hosts are always kept behind the firewall. In such case, if there is a huge attack, say 1 Gbps attack or 3 Gbps attack, then these firewalls are not capable to handle this attack, because they are not capable to analyze the data at the rate of 1 Gbps or 2 Gbps or 3 Gbps. Okay, we have anomaly detector which can analyze the data at the wire rate basically. Okay, the data is coming and a copy of all data is given to anomaly detector. Anomaly detector always keeps scanning the data, and if it finds any anomaly, any malicious traffic, it immediately activates the anomaly guard. That time only anomaly guard comes in picture, and all traffic is routed through anomaly guard. Okay, anomaly guard has 7 level of filtering. Okay, different 7 level of filtering, and we have a policy like fin request, SYN request, number of TCP connections, number of UDP connections, and even bandwidth allocation, you can say committed access rate to the server. Then according against these policy thresholds, anomaly guard checks incoming traffic and it filters the traffic. All legitimate traffic is allowed to go to the host, and all malicious traffic is dropped by anomaly guard. IP theft point of view, or from ARP spoofing point of view, we have implemented ARP access list in our data center. Say if there is a subnet, and every subnet has a gateway, so all the customers which are connected into that subnet, data of their servers passes through subnet. In this case, if one of the customer assigns the IP address of gateway to his server, then there is possibility that other host will route their data to that assigned IP address basically, which is not the legitimate gateway basically. So this is the IP theft process. So to avoid such kind of IP theft process, we have implemented ARP access list. When we allow any IP, we always bind IP address with the MAC address. So without ARP binding in our switch, no IP will be usable if even though customer assigns that IP to his system. From server level point, server point of view, we say if this is a Linux, if this is the server is of Linux machine, we implement the IP table firewall, we implement CCSF firewall. We allow only the running services. Say if customer is running only HTTP service, then we will configure it from CSF or IP tables so that this HTTP service will be allowed and all other services will be disabled. From etc host file also we do security tweaks, and if say customer is accessing his site from particular subnet or particular IP address or particular locations, then we can allow those particular IPs from access list or etc host dot allow dot file. This is server point of view. This is our monitoring system. We monitor our ISP's bandwidth here. We monitor incoming traffic as well as outgoing traffic. We have multiple routers here as active router and passive routers. So we monitor traffic of both routers, passive and active. Green graph shows incoming data and the blue line shows outgoing data. We have also implemented thresholding system in this, and if bandwidth goes above that threshold, the graph becomes red. When graph becomes red, our NOC engineers, you can see sitting here, they immediately starts looking into the issue. They starts finding the source IP address and the destination IP address, from where the traffic is coming and why and which service is accessing this much data or bandwidth. If we find it legitimate, find it okay, and if we find that it is not legitimate, then we immediately start looking into this. We have implemented grid monitoring of our system. Every component of this grid, you can see these green tabs, basically they represents a entire rack. We have a switch in a rack and all servers are connected to that rack. If any server goes down, green tab becomes red. Okay, then our network engineers or NOC engineers immediately look into the issue, which server is down, and we start providing proactive services to our client. We immediately check if the server is still down, we send a mail to our client. There is possibility that client might be working on the server and he might have shut down his server or rebooted his server. If it is not the case, then we will start looking into the issue. So by monitoring the system, we provide proactive services to our client. In second monitoring system, we have the ARP access list and all the IP addresses which we have not authorized to send data or to send traffic, we are listed here, and we see and we find out which customer has assigned unauthorized IP address to his server, and then we immediately ask that customer to remove that IP address from his server. Here is the output of camera which are installed in our data center. If anybody goes into data center, we keep monitoring what he is doing. Even though he is a NOC engineer, he is a network engineer, if he is working in the data center, we always keep monitoring what he is doing. Something has happened due to NOC engineer, then we will immediately catch him that why he has done this thing or why he has made this mistake, basically. For this purpose, we have implemented IP cameras in our data center, which continuously keeps recording of all motions happening in data center. This is a very important monitoring for us. We keep monitoring our UPS and the batteries, status of battery and charge, remaining battery, for how much time batteries will work, basically in case of power failure. We always monitor the spikes in voltage as well as current. If something happens wrong, then we can immediately see, say if there is a spike in current, maybe if input current or input voltage has increased, then we can immediately see incoming input voltage as well as output voltage. And if say we have a redundant UPS system, if one UPS goes down, we can immediately see that output graph of that UPS has come down, and we can immediately start working on that. Okay, this is a system which is very critical for us.